Subula remaja inilah persoalan di benak orang ramai.
Rasanya di sudut tunggal bakal tinggal kenangan
bagai masalah sosial di balik.
Selamat datang ke rancangan Bicara.
Bicara malam ini seorang saintis dan jurutera Muslim yang boleh dianggap sebagai antara yang terbaik di dunia sekarang ini, iaitu Profesor Jackie Ying. Beliau kini pengarah eksekutif di Institut Biokejuruteraan dan Nanotechnologi IBN. Profesor Ying pernah dinobatkan sebagai salah seorang daripada 100 jurutera era moden oleh Institut Jurutera Kimia Amerika. Semasa berusia 35 tahun, Prof Ying juga mencatat sejarah menjadi yang termuda diangkat sebagai profesor penuh di Institut Teknologi Massachusetts yang berprestij. Yang pasti, Prof Jackie Ying seorang saintis bertaraf bintang di peringkat global. Sejak 2012, beliau juga selama 5 tahun berturut-turut termasuk dalam senarai 500 Muslim paling berpengaruh di dunia. Dan baru-baru ini, Prof Ying dijulang dengan anugerah Hadiah Mustafa dari pemerintah Iran kerana sumbangan cemerlang beliau dalam bidang nanoteknologi dalam membantu pesakit kencing manis mengendalikan paras glukos darah tanpa perlu mencucuk jari pesakit untuk memantaunya. Kejayaan beliau itu membanggakan Singapura kerana ia menunjukkan masyarakat Islam Singapura ada bakat seperti beliau dan sekaligus meletakkan Muslim Singapura dalam peta dunia tokoh sains peringkat tinggi. Pendeknya, pencapaian, kepujian dan anugerah yang Profesor Ying sudah terima terlalu banyak untuk dibariskan. Dalam Bicara malam ini, kami bawa anda mengenali lebih dekat lagi pemikiran wanita kelahiran Taiwan ini yang pernah mendapat pendidikan di Sekolah Perempuan Raffles dan memeluk Islam sekitar 15 tahun lalu. Profesor Jackie Ying, selamat datang ke Rancangan Bicara.
Thank you.
Baik, pertama sekali ya, siapa dia genius yang bernama Jackie Ying ini ya? Apa jawapan ringkas anda?
Oh, I don't think I'm a genius. I think if anything, I tend to take a lot of time to do something well and do something right. So I'm far from being a genius.
Baik, IBN di bawah kepimpinan anda ya sudah membuat sumbangan begitu besar sekali untuk Singapura dan juga untuk negara di luar Singapura. IBN sudah menghasilkan lebih 1,000 penerbitan di majalah-majalah yang terkemuka dan lebih 500 paten dan aplikasi ya. Mewujudkan 9 syarikat sampingan dan juga sekitar 90 teknologi berlesen ya. Jelaskan kepada kami semua ini apa pengertiannya untuk Singapura.
What we really hope that we can do is through research make a technological impact, and a lot of the technologies that we have developed, we have more than 400 primary patents. We hope that they will be utilized. So we have actually worked very hard to try to commercialize more than 80 of them. So this, I think, will make an impact both clinically and also in other aspects, different industrial sectors. Many of the technologies that we develop are aimed at improving healthcare, for example, early detection of diseases, as well as better treatment for diseases.
Baik, Profesor Ying, kejayaan anda ya dianugerahkan Hadiah Mustafa ya menjadi satu dorongan besar kepada imej masyarakat Muslim di Singapura ya, bahawa kita ada orang seperti anda, seperti Profesor Ying. Tetapi memandang di sekeliling Singapura ya, nampaknya anda seorang saja saintis Muslim di Singapura yang kita perasan yang benar-benar sudah sampai, kata orang ya.
We actually have quite a number of Muslim scientists and we certainly have quite a lot of Muslim engineers. But of course, the number we would like to see even more. This will be very important. A lot of young people are now in research locally, and some of them are certainly Malays and Muslims. And our job is actually to make sure that the opportunity is open to everybody. So we have a youth research program, which my colleague Norina Abubakar has started in our institute, in the youth research program that allow us to basically draw a lot of students. For example, over 93,000 students have visited our institute through open houses, workshop, etc. And some of these students then will apply to our institute to do research attachment.
Baik, apa pemerhatian anda ya, Prof Ying? Apa sebabnya yang menyebabkan kurangnya orang Melayu Islam bergiat dalam sains dan kajian seperti dalam ISTA, seperti dalam IBN?
I would say that in IBN, we have quite a number of young Muslim and Malay staff. They came actually mostly by our youth research program. So over the years, we have about 2,300 students joining us for the youth research program. And some of them also have subsequently joined us as staff. I would say right now, we have probably about 10 Muslim Malay staff. And quite a number of them actually were our youth research program students. So the youth research program has reached out, I would say, very successfully to young people from all races in Singapore to get them excited about doing research. Every year, we have more than 600 students apply. And of that, we take in about 200 students. So each of our staff basically, on average, mentor 2 students and guide them do research for a period of at least 1 month on a full-time basis. And these students, we hope to basically inspire them by showing them the type of work that we do and what impact we can have, and encourage them to pursue science and engineering. But the reality is, research is really hard work. So not so many people will want to do this kind of work. They must be passionate about science, and secondly, they must find that this line of work is going to be meaningful for them, because it just requires so much hard work before you can get some good results. I personally, when I begin as a graduate student at Princeton University for my PhD, I started working 75, 80 hours a week. Okay, and not many people are willing to work very long hours. And I would say I still do that even now, but not many people are willing to do such kind of hard work for many years. Some of them may do it when they are PhD students, some of them might do it when they are postdoc, but to sustain something requires a great deal of passion and interest.
Dan apa yang anda korbankan ya?
A lot of personal time, yeah. I have a daughter, so I try to spend some time with her. But yeah, it's a lot of personal time, yeah. So, for example, I have no time for watching TV, you know, and I try to do some reading, but I also don't have so much time to read outside my technical field. Yeah, so it's always, what we do is very much a big part of our life, you know. Yeah.
Perhatian, cabutan bertuah Golden Chance kembali lagi dengan wang tunai hampir $88,000 untuk dimenangi. 56 pemenang. Pemenang perdana akan memenangi $22,222. Golden Chance, kedai emas yang diyakini.
You are going to be messed up. You will be dressed in clothes that are smelly.
Oh my gosh.
I want you all to eat, Gurney. Rookies, you are required to film a 30-second TV commercial to promote your social cause.
Global warming.
I'll play a part in the
freezing.
Find out in Octo Star Squad, Sunday, 12 noon.
An Octo Original. Octo Original.
Pada hari ini saya berikan semua adalah daripada institut-institut pengajian tinggi di Singapura ini. Definisi kejayaan bagi anda.
Terima kasih, penonton sekali lampaknya. Kita mesti cepat, ya.
Tapi nanti lain kali kita kasih you soalan senang sajalah. Ah.
Okey, ni takut pelakon ke apa ni?
5,000, 5,000, 5,000.
Yes! Yeah.
Kita orang Singapura. Isnin 8:30 malam di Suria.
Bangun jelas, satu kali makan, hari-hari mau. Sabuji, saya datang untuk makanan kegemaran saya.
In your Friday night movie on 5, it happened once.
You're that poor girl who was abducted last year.
Now, it's happening again.
This guy's back. Took my sister because I wasn't there.
But you never got a good look at him.
Do you want me to come to you? Or do you want to come to me?
Friday.
terdapat 1001 kisah yang mungkin menyayat hati.
Umur 15 tahun tu dah ada simptom lah. Selepas tu saya sakit buah pinggang. Memang perasaan berkecamuk pun ada lah.
Nak menerima hakikat tu payah eh. Dia terfikir mana silapnya.
Dan ada yang memberi harapan untuk kehidupan yang lebih bererti.
I mean, tak suka give up. Have to berusaha. And one thing, tak mau sedih.
Siri baru, Symptom, mulai 2 Mac setiap Rabu 9 malam di Suria. NKF dan Geng Sihat menggalakkan makan betul bersenam dan ambil pemeriksaan kesihatan.
Get your business noticed by 3.8 million people. Register now for TV Connect, the once-a-year television marketing event. 7 convenient sessions a day, March 7th to 11th at Marina Bay Sands. Register now.
Apa lagi yang boleh kita lakukan ya? Masyarakat Melayu Islam lakukan untuk menggalak dan menjana dan akhirnya untuk menghasilkan sekumpulan pengamal ya atau sarjana dalam bidang ini ya. Apa yang boleh kita buat untuk menjadikan sains atau kajian sains ini lebih seksi lah di kalangan para pelajar Melayu Islam ini?
I think it's actually the same problem for everybody. Basically, students learn science in school as a fairly dry subject, but actually the way we practice science, we do a lot of experiments. Okay, so when students have the opportunity to come to the lab, and then they can see all the interesting, exciting experiments that we do, which are also a lot of fun, and then they can see the impact of these experiments, how they can make a difference in the world, then I think they will be really excited about doing it. And that's why I think the youth research program has been very successful.
Jadi adakah anda menyatakan ya bahawa sekolah-sekolah kita mengajar sains dengan cara yang salah ya?
You know, this is something that it's very important to understand, because we can spend significant amount of resources into the infrastructure of the school. Okay, we can even improve the teacher to student ratio. But at the end of the day, science needs to be done in the lab. Okay. And so, really, having very good laboratory facilities and having very good science teachers who can condense all the complex theory and information into something that the students can relate to and turn it into intuition and knowledge that sticks with them is really critical. So these are things that I think we can always do better. There's always room for improvement. Many people, I would say, they study science at a younger age, but then they drop science going to university. So this is a problem. This is a very big problem for the pipeline. Yeah.
Okay, Prof. Mungkin jawapan kepada soalan ini ya akan menjadi petua kepada para ibu bapa di luar sana ya, yang mungkin mahu menggalak anak mereka supaya lebih mencintai sains ya. Anda punya seorang anak ya, anak perempuan, dan bagaimana anda mengasuh anak anda supaya dia juga minat dengan sains ya? Formula atau acuan apa yang anda gunakan ya?
I think she started asking me a lot of questions from young, and I would do experiments, do simple experiments with soap, with vinegar, you know, at home. Just do things that actually is not so different from cooking, you know. You see, there are many tricks on how to do things, and then their intuition on what works right, right? I think that things that I introduced to her, because from young she goes to scientific conferences with me, okay, but there are also things she learned in school. I would say that her teachers play a very important role. For example, last year she had a very good biology teacher. Okay, and this year she had a really good chemistry teacher. So suddenly she's become very interested in chemistry. So our teachers are really critical. Okay, so we also invite our teachers from our school system to come do research with us, because I'm sure they always want to also see what are the latest things that we are doing.
Baik, Prof Ying, saya kira mungkin anda satu hari nanti ya akan mungkin akan menjadi calon atau seorang pemenang hadiah Nobel ya, bagi fizik atau kimia atau mungkin perubatan juga ya. Kita belum lagi mendengar adanya seorang pemenang hadiah Nobel yang datang daripada bangsa Melayu ya. Apakah anda melihat bahawa kita ada bakat-bakat Melayu Islam yang berpotensi untuk menjadi seorang pemenang hadiah Nobel pada masa depan, anda banyak bergaul dengan para saintis Melayu Islam di peringkat yang tinggi. Jadi saya kira anda mempunyai perhatian atau mempunyai jawapan yang lebih baik ya kalau saya tanyakan soalan ini.
Currently, no. The ones that we have are really, I would say there are quite a number of young people. And as you correctly mentioned earlier, there is a lack of critical mass, okay, in the generation that could be considered now. But it's hard to say what will happen in the future. I would say that in Singapore, we notice a lot of young people who are very capable, okay. But doing well academically is different from being able to do research well in the lab, okay? And that really requires a different mindset and requires a lot of hard work. We have too much a civil service type of mindset with our scholars and with some of the staff that we have. It's a problem because I would say that the distinct difference between some of the young people we have here versus some of the top students I had in the States is that the top students we have, for example, MIT, I will call them at lunchtime here, which is, you know, midnight, that I will find some of them in the lab. Ah. They are that interested in doing their work and obtaining great results. That's what drives them, you know. And I think we are lacking this kind of passion. But here, I think that's too much emphasis on exams, okay? And those who do well become very book smart, and those who don't do well like to take a very different path completely. And I'm sorry to say that some of our young people in the community are doing that, and this is really unfortunate. This is actually not what education is about. We should not choose a path for them too early, right? For example, we string them too early, and that caused a lot of problem because people might not realize actually they're really interested in science or research. They might realize, oh no, I'm taking these subjects. I cannot even go into certain major later on when they go to university. And this is really very sad. Yeah. We are expecting them to know what they want to do when they're too young.
Are you a marketer seeking to unlock the growth potential of your business this year? Mediacom makes it easy and affordable to grow your business. At our complimentary TV Connect seminars, it takes just 45 minutes to discover the key to attracting and keeping new customers. Get your business noticed by 3.8 million people and harness the power of our channels with exclusive event-only packages. 7 sessions a day, March 7th to 11th at Marina Bay Sands. Secure your place by registering now.
Apa ni? Banyak sangat upaya.
Selamat pagi, Kak.
Hey, Suhaimi. Akak baru nampak dekat TV semalam.
Akak nak saya bantu pasang TV digital?
Eh, awak tahulah pasang TV digital ni.
Mestilah. Saya datang sini pun untuk hantar kotak set-top supaya kakak dapat tonton saluran-saluran TV digital.
Ah, sila masuk.
Pertama, jika anda gunakan TV yang bukan sedia digital, gunakan kabel untuk sambungkan antena ke kotak set-top. Kemudian, sambungkan kotak set-top ke TV dengan kabel HDMI atau kabel AV 3 warna bergantung kepada port TV anda. Jika anda menggunakan kotak set-top, pastikan anda pilih HDMI atau AV dengan menggunakan butang source. Kemudian, gunakan alat kawalan kotak set-top untuk mencari saluran TV. Kedua, jika TV anda sudah sedia digital, ia lebih mudah kerana ia sudah dilengkapi dengan tuner digital TVB T2. Anda hanya perlu sambungkan antena dan TV dengan kabel antena. Setelah semua sambungan selesai, cari saluran TV digital mengikut arahan-arahan yang tertera di skrin. Untuk mengetahui jika TV atau kotak set-top adalah sedia digital, anda hanya perlu cari label pengguna TV apabila membeli peralatan. Ta-da!
Wah, dah terang sekarang. Terima kasih, Suhaimi.
Untuk maklumat lanjut, longsuri videocorp.sg/digitalTV.
Boleh, Abang Mo.
Tetap sempurna dan meriah.
Dua pasangan dengan dua tema majlis yang berbeza.
This is our parents punya majlis. Kita tak leave out barang elemen-elemen yang important dalam adat kita lah.
Dia sebagai saya punya aunt Agony lah.
Saya tak pernah ada hati nak jumpa dia. Tak tahu kenapa.
Saksikan siri terbaru Demi Cinta 9 malam ini di Suria. Suka.
anda sebenarnya seorang ikon bagi masyarakat Muslim, bukan sahaja di Singapura ya, tapi di seluruh dunia saya kira. Jadi tak sempurna kalau soalan ini saya tidak tanyakan kepada anda ya. Berapa lama anda ambil ya sebelum anda memeluk agama Islam dan kenapa anda pilih agama Islam ya sebagai pegangan hidup anda, walaupun ada kepercayaan lain yang juga percaya kepada Sang Pencipta ya.
It is really only until secondary school. I was in Singapore for primary school and secondary school education that I realized, oh, okay, people actually have very different faiths. Okay. So I was in a Chinese stream primary school. So I don't have any Malay friends until I go to secondary school. Then I discovered, people have very different background, very different faith. And I become very curious. Because from young, I was always asking, what's the meaning and what's the purpose of life? Yeah. So in religion, we find a lot of the answers to that question. So over a very long period of time, I slowly learned about the religion. Maybe about 14, 15 years ago, I officially convert. Yeah.
Dan anda seorang saintis. Kongsi dengan kami ya. Sebenarnya apa kaitan antara agama dengan sains?
Our religion always teaches us to seek knowledge, right? Because the knowledge can be very useful for our society, our community. And also, I would say, a lot of scientific knowledge points again and again to the existence of God. Yeah. So I think the two doesn't have problem with each other. People always ask me, is there a conflict between religion and science? I say, no, not whatsoever. For example, we are looking at bioengineering, right? Bioengineering is about learning about the complexity in biology, okay? And sometimes we cannot fully understand everything, but we can easily appreciate how complex the human body is, for example, right? What's the probability of that come to being by itself? The probability is really very, very small. So it's got to be a creator, right? That we are all born in a manner that is really fairly free from defects, okay? So this actually again and again affirms the existence of Allah, right? I believe. It wasn't difficult for me to actually accept Islam. To me, it's a very simple religion. It's much easier for me to accept, the other more complicated religious concepts. So Islam is very simple religion, but at the same time, I think most people who are not familiar with the religion will be very, very surprised to realize that how much knowledge there is in this religion. So the depth of knowledge is tremendous. When I first opened the Quran, I mean, it was very clear to me, this book is very, very special and very unusual book. Yeah, because it has so much information in it that in those days, for example, the scientific knowledge would not have been able to describe in such details. And yet it was all in the Quran.
Juga tidak kurang menarik ya bahwa anda jumpa Islam kerana anda hidup dalam masyarakat yang beribang bangsa ya.
I would say that I'm very happy living in Singapore. One of the reasons is basically this country is multiracial and people live in harmony. It's very unusual. I think it's very, very unusual. The government and the people, I think, are really very special in creating this environment that people not just tolerate, but actually live together very nicely and peacefully, have a lot of understanding of each other. Yeah.
Baik Prof Ying, ya, kalau kita di Singapura atau di Malaysia ya, kita menyebut tentang seorang Muslim ya, kita lazimnya juga mengaitkan mereka dengan orang Melayu ya. Jadi ingin saya tanyakan kepada anda ya, apakah ada sedikit kemelayuan dalam diri anda?
To me, there are a lot of things that people like to use to differentiate amongst the people, huh? For example, race, language, religion, etc. I think it's actually very sad because we are all human beings. yeah, and there are a lot more things in common between the people than you know, having the same religion or the same race, etc. I suppose we all have that in us, and I must say that my best friend, she's from a Malay family. Her family kind of adopted me, in a sense. So they would spend Hari Raya with me. Eh? And at the same time, when I have celebrate Chinese New Year, I have also these Malay families and friends coming to visit me. So to me, that's really, I think it goes both ways. The Malay community also adopted me. You know, when you wear the tudung, they recognize you. They will always salam you. I think there's nothing more beautiful than that.
Baik, apa dia mungkin satu ciptaan anda ya, menjadi impian anda secara pribadi ya, untuk anda cipta, untuk anda bina atau sebagainya ya, sebagai seorang saintis dan pengkaji. Katalah jika anda boleh hidup selama 100 tahun ya.
There are many exciting research that we are currently doing. I say this because sometimes people think, oh, you're at a certain age, your best work is already done. But I feel very much that the best is yet to come because I've now reached a certain level of maturity in my work. I have a lot of dreams of what I want to do. And I also have now a great team in our institute. There are a lot of other diseases, or rather I would say illness, associated with aging, okay? If we do live to 100 years old, right, many of the body parts will need to be replaced. So when we talk about regenerative medicine, the key is really in ability to make use of stem cell type of technology. So we are very interested in developing methods that we can expand large numbers of stem cells, okay, and differentiate and control them to differentiate to certain type of cells, and so that they can be used for therapy, so that they can be used for regenerative medicine. We're interested in developing materials that will help the growth of the stem cells, and also we are interested in developing a bioreactor type of technology where we can monitor the growth of these stem cells and make sure that they really reach the level of quality that they can actually be used inside the body. Regenerative medicine, I think, is a very long-term goal. But it is something that we need to work on now, yeah, and so that it will happen in, you know, say 10, 20 years down the road, okay. And when we look at this, again, I think it's very interesting because how come there are certain cells has this regenerative ability, and how can we harness it, okay, and introduce this into different people and help them overcome certain illnesses and diseases. I think this is something that is a huge topic, and how to make them in large enough quantity that scientists can then do all the experiments they want to do and develop them for real clinical applications, I think really is a very important field, and it's very interdisciplinary. It cuts across biology, medicine, and engineering.
Mm. Prof Ying, ini satu soalan yang saya tanyakan pada permulaan wawancara tadi ya. Dan saya mahu tanyakan sekali lagi ya, siapa sebenarnya Jackie Ying ya? Apa yang membuatkan anda Jackie Ying?
I think from young, we wanted to grow up in and be individuals, okay. And it was very important for me that my parents never set me in certain pigeonholes and say, you'll be like this or you'll be like this. They are very accepting of who I am. And they never tell me, oh, you cannot do that because you're a girl, you're a woman, whatever it is. There was no such limitations that were drawn for me. Of course, society is a different story. Yeah, we have a lot of constraints. But I think partly because my parents had never set those limitations for me, I never felt that there's something I cannot do and accomplish if I set my mind to doing it. And I think it's that we always set our own challenge that makes it possible for us to try different things. Yeah.
Profesor Jackie Ying, terima kasih kerana sudi berbicara dengan kita kali ini.
Thank you.
boleh ditonton melalui catch up di toggle.sg.
Super Fountain!
Dua.